Learn about the crucial metrics you need to monitor in Azure Monitor to keep your VMs healthy and monitored this week on Data Exposed. Hi, I'm Anna Hoffman, and welcome to this episode of Data Exposed. Today, I'm joined by David Pless, a program manager on the Azure SQL team. David, thanks so much for joining us today.
Hello, Anna. Happy to be here.
We are happy to have you here. Now, in previous sessions, we have talked about virtual machines, uncached versus cached performance. But today, we want to examine the Azure Monitor and metrics that can help us track resource health and virtual machine and storage levels. So, you know, to kind of get into this, you know, David, what is the purpose for tracking VM cache health for SQL VMs?
Yeah, basically the remote storage that we have for our virtual machines should be measured in terms of IOPS and throughput. IOPS being the number of requests to storage or the virtual machine, and throughput being the amount of data that's transferred. Our disk and the virtual machines have limits for IOPS and throughput. And when we hit those performance limits, that's when we're getting capped at those levels. But there's two limits. And we talked about this in our previous Data Exposed sessions. The max uncached disk throughput is the default storage maximum limit that the virtual machine can handle. And the max cached storage limit is a separate limit, but only applies when you enable host caching. And as we've discussed, we definitely want to enable host caching for the data desk. Host caching works by bringing storage closer to the virtual machine that can be written to or read from very quickly. And the amount of storage that's available to the virtual machine for host caching is going to differ between the VM series and size. The machine that we're going to look at today, and you'll see that I named it DP SQL Gen 01. That is a D8S V3 that comes with 200 gigs of cache storage, 16,000 IOPS, and 128 megs of throughput. But these are the uncached limits. So when we enable caching, we're gonna get about a 30% bump in most workloads when we enable read caching for the data disk. And it's read only for the data disk, and no caching for the log. With, last thing to say here, with tempdb on being placed on the ephemeral D drive in most cases. That's the best practice scenario, and it's what our storage configuration leans us towards.
Cool. Do you have something, like, can we take a look?
Absolutely. So yes, I have two tabs that I've set up, and I'm doing this so we can look at the metrics separately and like how to find the metrics and pin the metrics. And then what a dashboard looks like that I've already had some metrics pinned to. The first thing I want to show, though, like down here, there's a grouping for monitoring where we have insights, alerts, and metrics. And I'm doing this specifically in the VM. Like I already went to the virtual machine blade, clicked into the virtual machine. That's something that's really important to understand, that I can get to the metrics here. I can look at it holistically through Azure Monitor. And I think, Anna, you have that link that you've shared. I think we had a couple of links. One is for Azure Monitor, and the other is to talk about some of the metrics that we're going to look at. Here, I want to start, though, at, because sometimes this can get overlooked, at the overview. And we have a tab here for monitoring. So when you click this monitoring tab, there's a couple of things I want to point out. One is anytime you see this pin, this means that I can click this pin and pin it to an existing dashboard or a new dashboard. Okay, so this is how, and I get this question all the time, I show this view and folks are like, how did you do that? This looks great, I would love to have something custom too. This is how I did it. Essentially what you can do is take a number of apps and tiles and pin it to a dashboard, and you can take your metrics, it just refreshed, it doesn't auto refresh, and you can take your metrics and pin those to this view. I'll talk a little bit about what we're seeing here, and you can see that this is already populating. I already have a workload running, but let's start with like, how do I pin these things? So all you have to do is click these. And if you notice, we have the metrics of CPU, network, disk bytes, disk operations per second. That's my IOP and my throughput, and then my memory health, right? Now, if I were to click into any of these, if I was to click into memory bytes preview, I'm going into metrics here where I could start adding additional metrics and continuing to modify the line chart that I have expressed here. I can change it to an area view. I can do a few things here to get to the data and look at it in a particular way. And all I had to do is go into the overview and then click into this monitoring section. So that's great. It's a really quick start. It's really nice to be able to see this up front. What I want to show you next, though, because, and I think we have that Azure storage metrics reference that goes, it's specific to the metrics that helps diagnose disk IO capping and that helps you diagnose VM IO capping. What if you just want, like, I just need to see this myself. I just want to populate these as I wish, right? So what all you have to do, and what's nice is the search is really, really easy to get to. So if I say data disk IOPS, that's my data disk IOPS. I could add a metric for, let's say, my data disk bandwidth. And I'm grabbing this. And what I would recommend doing is grouping these kind of by purpose. And in this case, my purpose is my data disks. So these are like, you know, let's say your data file, your log file. And if I had TempDB placed on a remote disk, that would be my data disk. But my OS disks, right? So let's grab these two. OS disk IOPS. It's really nice that I can be able to search.
I noticed, David, you're adding all of these metrics are the consumed percentage. Is that, right, you know, an important thing for folks to look at?
Yeah, these are the key ones. Like all of the, it's a really important point that you're bringing up. Let me grab OS data bandwidth, I think is what I was looking at. OS data disk bandwidth, there we go. Okay, yeah, so it's a really important point that you're bringing up. So here's all you need to know. So we have essentially eight metrics. Data disk, OS disk, IOPS, and bandwidth. Bandwidth being the throughput, that's at the storage level. VM, cached IOPS, cached bandwidth, uncached IOPS, and uncached bandwidth. Eight counters. And I'll show you this on the other dashboard. If you get to 100% on any of those, you know that you've reached the limit for that metric. It's that simple. So yes, that's a great question. The consumed percentage is very important. And those are why we specifically target those eight counters. So speaking of those eight counters, and I have been running disk speed in various shapes and sizes to sort of punish this VM and push it against those limits, is let's take a look here. And if you see, these are those eight counters. I'm going to scroll down just a tad. So I have these eight counters, and I grouped these, as I said, by purpose. This is my virtual machine like set, and this is my data disk set. And we can see here that I'm going to scroll down just a tad. I'm highlighting on data disk consumed percentage. I'm hitting around 66, 67%, but what is the cap? What is the limit? I'm being limited at the VM in this case, because I can see that my cache bandwidth is 100%, and so is my this uncached bandwidth. You'll see that it reaches 100% as well. So in this case, better storage does not help me. I either need to tune my workload or resize the VM. And you're getting all of that just by looking at Azure Monitor metrics.
Awesome. Yeah, this is a great, simple way to kind of diagnose, is it at the VM level or the data disk level? So these are really useful. And I think, you know, everyone probably using SQL Server virtual machines should be pinning these or monitoring these in some shape or form. You know, David, this has been really useful. Any final words of advice for users who are starting to monitor their VMs?
Start simple, group by purpose, keep your VM counter set separate from your data disk set, separate from your OS set. Remember that if you're looking at VM cache health, you have to do it from the Azure Monitor metrics perspective. I absolutely still recommend leveraging Perfmon on the VM, especially if you've already grabbed those source counters, and we talked about that in the data exposed session. Grabbing your source metrics, targeting those metrics, and continuing that monitoring approach even after you've migrated to the cloud, because it's consistent and you'll actually get a good idea of the shape of your performance over time. But again, if you want to look at the health of the VM itself, especially the cache, you really need to do it through Azure Monitor Metrics.
Awesome. That's great advice, great tips. Thank you so much, David, for coming on the show today. For our viewers, thanks for joining as well. We put some links in the description for you to learn more about these different metrics and how to get them set up. And if you like this video, go ahead and give it a like, subscribe to our channel, and we hope to see you next time on Data Exposed.